What does herpes look like in a female? More women than men are affected by HSV2. This is because herpes is more easily transmitted to the female partner during sex. Since genital herpes cannot be cured, the number of infected people in a population can only grow as more and more people become infected. The only way to reduce genital herpes within a population is through prevention. Oral herpes caused by HSV1 can also be a source of genital herpes. Across the world, it is estimated that 2 out of 3 people under 50 years of age, around 3.7 billion people, are infected with HSV1. In women and people with female reproductive tracts, herpes lesions can appear on the vulva, perineum, buttocks, anal area, cervix, and inside of the vagina. And some people may experience spotting and vaginal discharge. This means that people with vaginas may not be able to see any herpes blisters because they are inside the vaginal canal. The first outbreak may also be accompanied by full body symptoms, such as fever, body aches, and swollen lymph nodes. The first outbreak of genital herpes lesions usually lasts between 2 to 4 weeks long. While skin symptoms are present, a person is very contagious, as herpes viruses are present in the blister fluid and over the entire infected area. How can I prevent contracting or spreading genital herpes? Always use a condom and/or barriers. Being sexually active puts people at risk for contracting STI. Practicing safer sex and using condoms can moderately reduce the risk of contracting genital herpes. People who use condoms every time they have sex are 30% less likely to contract genital herpes. Condoms should be used before any genital or sexual contact begins, not just during ejaculation. Since outbreaks and viral shedding may occur in areas not covered by a condom, total protection, even with perfect and consistent condom use, cannot be guaranteed. Do a visual scan. People with outbreaks, herpes blisters present in the genital area, should abstain from sexual activity until the sores have fully healed. The risk of transmission of genital herpes is highest during outbreaks, when viral shedding is at its greatest. If a person with genital herpes feels prodrome symptoms, they sense that a herpes outbreak will happen soon, then sexual intercourse should be avoided until after the outbreak has subsided, and all of the blisters and ulcers have completely healed. Ask about sexual history. Ask all partners whether they've been tested recently for STIs before sexual contact. Limiting the number of sexual partners you are exposed to will also decrease your risk of contracting genital herpes and other STIs. If you've had unprotected sex, or if you experience symptoms of genital herpes, visit your health care provider or local STI clinic for STI screenings. If you have genital herpes, be open with your partner and talk about the risks of transmission. Douching should be avoided, as this may actually increase chances of contracting STI. Researchers are working towards the development of other preventative strategies, such as an HSV vaccine and topical microbicides to help prevent the spread of herpes. How is genital herpes diagnosed? To diagnose a genital herpes infection, a healthcare provider will inspect the lesions and discuss sexual history and, if applicable, previous herpes outbreaks. The provider may run lab tests of the lesions, or blood tests to detect the virus. How is genital herpes managed? The herpes simplex virus cannot be cured, but it can be managed using antiviral medications to help control outbreaks. These medications help to prevent the outbreaks from happening as often and to reduce the symptom severity and duration. There are 2 different treatments for people with genital herpes: suppressive therapy and episodic treatment. In suppressive therapy, antiviral medications are taken daily to reduce the frequency of herpes outbreaks. Having less frequent outbreaks means fewer episodes of painful genital lesions and less viral shedding, which will help reduce the risk of giving herpes to a partner. Episodic treatment may be better suited for people with infrequent outbreaks. Antivirals are dosed at the onset of symptoms to help ameliorate symptoms and shorten the duration of the outbreak. If you have genital herpes, talk to your healthcare practitioner to determine which management option is best for you. For people with herpes blisters inside the vagina, using tampons or menstrual cups during menstruation may be painful or irritating, making pads or menstrual underwear a better option during outbreaks. What are the potential complications of genital herpes? Pregnancy and herpes. It is possible to transmit a genital herpes infection from mother to the baby during birth. The rate of transmission depends on whether or not herpes lesions are present at the time of delivery. If no genital herpes lesions or prodromal symptoms are present at the onset of labor, then a mother with a known herpes infection can still deliver a healthy baby vaginally. But if a herpes outbreak is present at the time of delivery, or if the mother has recently just acquired genital herpes near the time of delivery, then a cesarean section will be performed to help reduce the risk of herpes transmission to the baby. If you are pregnant and you don't have genital herpes, avoid sex with anyone who you know or suspect has genital herpes, especially in the third trimester. Neonatal herpes. If a newborn infant is exposed to the herpes virus, the consequences can be severe and even fatal. Infants can develop infections in their skin, eyes or mouth, in their central nervous system, or even throughout their body, affecting multiple organ systems at once. HIV and genital herpes. Having HIV puts a person at greater risk of contracting genital herpes, and having genital herpes puts a person at greater risk of contracting HIV. Immunocompromised people, including people with HIV, often experience longer and more severe genital herpes outbreaks, and have increased herpes virus shedding. The open sores caused by herpes make transmission of both HIV and the herpes simplex virus more likely, CDC. It's estimated that people with genital herpes are 3 times more likely to contract HIV when exposed. Other impacts of genital herpes. It's important to also remember that there are mental and social impacts of having an incurable STI. Many people with recurrent genital herpes symptoms may feel stigmatized or fearful of pursuing sexual relationships. But people should remember, while genital herpes is not curable, it is manageable, and the outbreaks often decrease over time. What does herpes look like on a female? What does genital herpes look like on a female? What does herpes look like on a female genital? What does herpes look like on a black female? What does herpes look like female? What does a herpes outbreak look like on a female? What does genital herpes look like on a woman pictures? What does genital herpes look like female? What does genital herpes look like on a black female? What does herpes look like in a woman? Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to my channel for my upcoming herpes treatment videos.